Hello friends, welcome to our channel Nin's Kitchen Stories. Hope you all are doing well and safe at home. In today's video, I'm sharing a sweet recipe. It's a very simple, easy pudding recipe. It's caramel pineapple rava pudding or suji pudding without using egg. So let's start and first check out the ingredients. For this we need 1/4 cup of rava or suji, then 1/2 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup plus 3 tablespoons of sugar, 2 cup milk. We need vanilla essence and pineapple essence, then 1 tablespoon butter and 1 tablespoon corn flour. So let's start the preparation. First step is to caramelize the sugar. Take a pan and add 3 tablespoons of sugar. As shown in the video, spread the sugar evenly and cook until it gets caramelized. Caramelize the sugar until we get a nice golden brown color. Now our caramel syrup is ready. Immediately pour the caramel syrup into the pudding tray or to the mold. In case if the caramel syrup got hardened, don't be panic. Melt the caramel syrup by adding 1 or 2 tablespoons of water. First step, that is caramel syrup, is ready. Second step is to prepare the pudding mix. For that, in a saucepan, take 2 cups of milk. I'm taking full fat milk. And wait until milk boils. The milk has started to boil. You can see the bubbles forming. So it's boiled well. Now it's time to add the sugar. Here I'm adding 1/2 cup of sugar. You can adjust the sugar according to your taste preference. And wait until the sugar melts completely. The sugar has dissolved completely. Now it's time to add main ingredient, rava or suji. Here I used 1/4 cup of unroasted rava or suji. Try to use fine suji or rava. Cook rava for 1 to 2 minutes on low to medium flame. Now it's time to add 1 tablespoon of butter. Mix well and wait until it melts. Butter is optional. If you don't like to use butter, you can skip this step. But butter improves the taste of the pudding. You can see the butter has dissolved completely and even the suji is cooked well. But when we check the consistency of the pudding mix, it is loose in consistency. We need a thick batter. So for that, I'm using corn flour and water mix. So I have taken 1 tablespoon of corn flour mixed in 2 tablespoons of water. Now the corn flour mix is ready without any lumps. Now it's time to add this mix into the mixture. Combine the corn flour mix and stir well. Cook the mix until it thickens on low heat. So our pudding mix is ready. You can see the consistency. It is neither too loose nor too thick. It should be medium thick in consistency. Immediately divide the hot pudding mix into 1/2. To one portion, add the pineapple essence. Here I have used 1/4 teaspoon of pineapple essence. Mix and combine well. So our pineapple flavored pudding mix is ready. Sometimes we get pineapple essence without the yellow food color. In that case, you can use yellow food color, permitted yellow food color, or a pinch of turmeric powder. To the other 1/2, add vanilla essence. Here I used 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla essence. Combine well and keep this aside. 2 flavored pudding mix are ready. Now it's time to assemble the pudding tray or mold. Pour the 2 mix into the tray or mold. You can layer the pudding mix according to your wish. Either you can first layer the vanilla pudding mix, let it cool down little bit, then add the pineapple pudding mix. But here I have alternatively layered the 2 flavors. First 1 spoon of vanilla flavor, then pineapple flavor, then again vanilla flavor. It is alternatively I have added each flavors. So fill the pudding tray completely with the pudding mix. Now cover the pudding mix with a foil paper. We have to steam this pudding mix. So for that, I have taken a curry pan, or you can use a steamer. Add some water and place a stand and place the covered mold or tray. Cover with the lid and steam for 30 to 35 minutes on medium to low heat. Sorry, after 30 minutes I forgot to switch on the camera. I took the mold from steamer after 30 minutes and allowed it to cool and kept in refrigerator for 4 hours. After 4 hours, the pudding is well set now. Now it's time to demold the pudding. So once again, I am repeating this step. After 30 minutes, take the mold from the steamer, allow it to cool down completely, then keep in refrigerator for 4 hours to completely set the pudding. Then you can demold the rava pudding. So our beautiful, yummy, eggless rava pudding is ready. Now we can cut into pieces and serve. You can see it's very soft, well set, perfect in texture. So our mouth melting caramel pineapple rava pudding, eggless rava pudding is ready to be served. Garnish the pudding with some sliced pistachios or any nuts. If you like this video, stay tuned. Thank you and keep watching.